Hi, I'm David Dodge. Welcome to Green Energy Futures. Last time, we talked to Mark Anielski, the author of An Economy of Well-Being, about how measuring our well-being is actually good economics.
Wealth means the conditions of well-being, from the Old English. So when I talk about why should we measure well-being, A, it's just good economics. It's intuitive. And when I talk about how are we going to measure this through an accounting system I called genuine wealth, which means well-being aligned with what? Our genuine values. How are we going to measure this through an accounting system that looks more like a conventional balance sheet? Assets, liabilities.
Anielski says genuine wealth accounting tracks five kinds of capital: human, social, natural, built, and financial capital. Conventional economics cares about the last two, but Anielski says the balance sheet is incomplete without a full accounting of assets and liabilities.
I would start with this whole premise. I've said you start with an inventory, a balance sheet of the assets of the province. There is no balance sheet for Alberta.
The oil sands are an asset.
Say their production is 2.5 million barrels a day. It has a 190-year life, and it's an $8 trillion asset. Okay, that's one asset. What about renewable energy?
But there are natural capital assets that are not tracked in accounting systems, and the potential of these assets needs to be balanced against liabilities.
What I'm saying is, again, I'll go back to with a balance sheet, what you'd have is you would know what your energy assets are. You would know their market price. You would know that the unfunded liabilities around those, the orphan wells, the tailing ponds, those would all be on the books. They wouldn't be sort of guesstimates of environmental think tanks and advocates. They should be transparent and known to all Albertans.
These liabilities are worth billions of dollars, and future generations will be saddled with the costs. Anielski says carbon is another example.
What if we actually measure the unfunded carbon liability that we impose on the world? Not $50 a ton, but more. Now we start to think, okay, maybe we should accelerate the investment in PV, in net zero homes. These are assets that are going to deliver what? Future long-term well-being, but also reduced liabilities that any insurance company should like.
Anielski says genuine wealth accounting involves balancing the assets against the liabilities.
As an economist, I've done the math. There's no way oil revenues are going to come back the way they have in terms of royalties. So we're going to have to budget based on a smaller royalty regime. Can we do it? I think we can. But we have to get serious about investing in these other asset plays, because those are the assets that are going to deliver longer-term economic and financial resilience, even if we still only produce 2.5 million barrels a day.
Anielski says genuine wealth accounting would value natural capital resources, balance them against liabilities such as orphan wells, tailings ponds, and carbon pollution, and introduce actual measures of well-being into the accounting system.
I think it would just help us go to sleep at night feeling we made some wise decisions. We weren't romantic about renewables. We weren't romantic about oil and gas. We said we have energy assets that can be developed in responsible ways that ensures the future well-being of our grandchildren.
Mark Anielski's author of the new book, An Economy of Well-Being. Learn more at greenenergyfutures.ca. For Green Energy Futures, I'm David Dodge.
It's fun to charter an accountant and sail the wide accountancy, to find, explore the funds offshore and skirt the shoals of bankruptcy. It can be manly in insurance. We'll up your premiums semi-annually.